You've all seen that show before. Good guy reads the paint spatter on the wall, tests the DNA, and bags the killer all within 50 minutes. But how much of that is close to real life? Hey, future serial killers, Julia here for DNews. We all think that's how solving crimes works, right? The killer is an idiot who leaves traces of his DNA all over the place, and crime scene investigators use the latest tech to catch the bad guy. While this happens in Hollywood all the time, it's not exactly reality. And unfortunately, many people can't tell the difference. This is what's called the CSI effect. It's when these shows influence how the administration of justice plays out. Many jurors expect and demand that crimes be solved by super tech that doesn't really exist. But through a mix of old and new techniques, science helps solve even the most heinous of crimes. You might be surprised how much you can tell from just a drop of blood. When you get your blood drawn at the doctor's and shipped off to be tested, a lot can be revealed. From your blood cell count, your glucose and cholesterol levels, tests can tell if you have various diseases or viruses. It can even tell your biological age, not just your chronological age, according to a study published in the journal Nature. Things like bad diet, low exercise, and stress can make your body's cells appear older than how many trips you've taken around the sun. But that's blood that's collected in a precise clinical way. Blood stains on a hotel room carpet? Different story, there's less information there. Blood can tell a story of a crime, though. Blood spatter allows investigators to recreate the events that unfolded. It's actually an old science. The first systematic study of blood stains was published at the University of Vienna in 1895, titled On the Formation, Form, Direction, and Spreading of Blood Stains Resulting in Blood Trauma at the Head. But over the decades, it's gotten much more advanced. The field uses a mix of math and science to figure out what happened. According to the book Principles of Bloodstain Pattern Analysis, blood stains can be divided into three main categories: passive or gravity, spatter, and altered. Passive is like it sounds, like blood pooling under a victim. Spatter, on the other hand, well, the type of blood spatter can sometimes tell where an injury happened. Expirated bloodstain patterns comes from more natural occurrences like breathing, spitting, and coughing up blood. You can find bubbles in these stains from air pockets, and it might be a lighter color from being diluted from saliva. Altered means, like you would expect, that the stain has been altered in some way, like an object being dragged across it or an attempt at a cleanup. And according to a study published in SIAC Journal, the Journal for Police Science and Practice, impact spatter patterns indicate something traumatic, like a gunshot, blood force trauma, or from machinery. The blood drops extend outward from a point in direct lines. If it's an impact spatter, it's very likely that there is more than one blow to the victim, as the first blow never spreads much blood. But the effectiveness of such analyses are really varied. Depending on the amount of blood, a vague idea of a weapon, whether it's blunt or sharp, might be determined. The location and pattern of the blood can give investigators an idea of angle, velocity, and trajectory of the blood. By analyzing these kinds of patterns, they get an idea of how hard the force of impact was or what angle the attack came from. And of course, if there's enough blood, you can even find out someone's identity. DNA analysis is considered the gold standard of crime scene investigation reliability, but it took a while for that technology to advance. In the 70s, the only thing they could tell was which type of blood it was, which, depending on the type, could narrow the suspects down to 4% or 49% of the population. Now, using polymerase chain reaction, PCR technique, which takes a small piece of DNA and multiplies it hundreds of times so it's easier to see or analyze. After PCR, DNA then goes through a process called gel electrophoresis, which makes it easy to compare DNA samples. You've probably seen these on TV or maybe in your own biology lab at school. The gels look like columns with little lines that trap certain lengths of DNA fragments in different sections. By comparing how these lines match up to known or unknown other samples, researchers can either remove someone as a suspect or nail the sucker down. While blood can tell the story of a crime scene, the right domain name might tell yours. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. And because you watch DNews, you get 15% off domain.com's names and web hosting by using the code DNews when you check out. Of course, if evidence of the crime is wiped away with bleach, you're screwed. Or are you? To find out how blood can make a crime scene light up like the night sky, check out this video right here.
Let's say you're a criminal and you found yourself in a situation where there's a lot more than apparently I'm able to produce.
Yeah, for whatever reason, just a lot of blood.
And let's say you've got some bleach too.
So who's your favorite crime scene investigator? Nancy Drew, Sherlock Holmes? Tell us down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons so you don't miss a single episode of DNews.